Cuban Chocolate Festival is usually held in October to coincide with Cuban Culture Day. For the last two editions, it's been held from November through to December to match celebrations for the anniversary of the city's founding. Over the 5 days of the festival, participants will be able to enjoy literary and craft fairs, exhibitions by visual and performing artists, spaces for children and community events, as well as a broad program featuring artistic groups of various genres, formats, and for all tastes. That's it from me for today here on the Arts Roundup. But I'll be back again on Monday with more cultural news from Cuba here on the radio. That's Radio Havana, Cuba.
And that's it. Eight no more time for today. Thanks for joining us here on the radio. I have some great stuff for you tomorrow. Be with us here for the Jazz Place with Jorge the Jazz Man Milares. In the second hour, we have Music with a Message on our programming tomorrow, heard every week, every Saturday later on RHC Radio, Havana, Cuba. Special thanks to Tony Barrios, El Maestro, on the controls. General production by Roberto Bastidas. And tomorrow on the program, we'll be expecting to see you and you can be listening to us here on RHC right here on the radio. Off with our news from Cuba and around the world. Then we'll have Dr. Jose Rubiera. He has the weather report for us. We've got Susana Nieves with our commentary viewpoint for today. And on the final day of COP26, Natalie Howard brings us stories from youth activists impacted by climate change. On our weekly program, Voices, we bring you the voices of young second-year students from the Raul Roa Garcia Higher Institute of International Relations. On this week's program, they talk about the upcoming celebration of the 502nd anniversary of Havana, the Cuban capital.